Hi friends, welcome to Immigration News by Ting Law. Today we're going to discuss several factors on what to consider when hiring a law firm or a lawyer. And here's a bonus tip. Ask this potential lawyer how you're going to get a copy of the case file. For us, give you an example, we are very transparent. If we prepare a package and we send it out to the government, we give you a copy of that. We use a cloud service to share these documents. Okay, we create a folder just for our clients. We have the filing to the government. We have the notices. We have all the evidence that you've provided us already. We also have our estimated timeline and checklist in this folder. So it's an all-in-one location just for the client that we also have access to, okay? We can share documents in this folder. And our clients appreciate this because then they don't have to ask us, hey, where is this notice that I've been looking for? Because for some reason, I didn't receive it in the mail. Bam, it's right there. We share it at the outset of the case so that there's no confusion if a client has the access to it or not later on. We want to be transparent with our clients. And another bonus tip is ask the law firm or whoever you're talking to in the consultation, who is going to be your attorney? Now, especially with big law firms, it could be anyone. So, in most law firms' contracts, it does say that they can assign a case to any lawyer to work on your case. And the reason is because, honestly, for us, if someone is on vacation or out on trial for a week, someone else needs to be working on your case, right? But for the most part, you can still ask which lawyer it will work primarily on your case. Because then you can direct the questions to that lawyer at some point. Think of these questions where you're considering to hire an attorney. Now, please do not hire a notario or a notary because they do not have a legal license to practice law, especially these times during President Trump's administration. The policies, regulations, and laws are practically changing almost every week. And so I don't think a notary is following every single one. Please share this video to your friends as they're considering how to hire a lawyer, even if it's a different type of case, not immigration, but it could be for family law or for civil litigation, for example, or even criminal defense. Every lawyer needs to be organized. They need to have a communication policy, and they need to have a mentality of preparing for your case very diligently and timely. Friends, if you got value and you really enjoyed these tips on how to hire a lawyer, please hit subscribe down below, smash the like button, and leave a comment. Let us know what you're thinking about when you hire a lawyer. If you've been frustrated before with a lawyer, let us know, please, because we really encourage other lawyers as well on these tips and how they can be better organized. And you can see that in one of our other channels that we have about software. And that's how important it is to us. We want to share that value to other attorneys. And until the next episode, we'll see you soon.